We'll be talking about maximizing your yield. We'll be talking about terroir. We'll be talking about microbiology in the soil. We'll be talking about cover crop. We'll be talking about all of that shit. And we'll be talking about how it all comes together. And some of the stuff we still don't know yet. We're just gonna see it happen right in front of our eyes. That's what's beautiful about this, guys. Hey everyone, Mike from Green Grow Spaces here, and I know it's been a while, and I put out a video about a week ago, but I didn't really introduce it, I just kind of plopped it out for the first time in a very long time. So what I want to do is I want to take the time to kind of take you through a tour of the garden right now as it is, okay, and then get into the video that you're about to watch, which is a follow-up of the last video. So I'm basically about a few weeks ahead right now, okay, in this garden, because remember, I showed you those moms, and look at them now. Those moms were just tiny cuts before, and they're pretty monstrous now. I'm a few weeks ahead. What we're gonna do is I wanna show you how what I'm doing is helping to maximize my yield, my flavor, and my potency, all right? So we're gonna start with the flowering rooms, and we're gonna kind of take a tour around the garden, okay? All right, so here we are. Really quickly, I'll just take you through and show you what we've got going on in here. But right behind me, I've got a bed of sugar cookie. You can see right here. And that genetic was from Oregon, actually. And then over on this side, we've got Death Bubba. And these are in week four of flower. And you can tell that they're just gonna be fucking animals, man. Like, if I can get in on that. You can see the frost railing on that Death Bubba. Damn. Some of these are beasts. Like, look at the size of this. Look at the size of this. So these Death Bubbas are gonna be absolute monsters. And I've got them going in, as we can see here. Boom. Still got the cover crop. Clovers are massive. Everyone's happy down there, alive and well. These buds on the sugar cookies are fucking donkeys as well. Holy shit. Like, just serious. Serious. These things are gonna turn into fucking animals. It's only week four, guys. Week four of flower. Look at the size of this bud. And these are known to put out big buds, but I'm excited to see the size of the Death Bubbas on this size. Pretty much the same fucking size, man. So, you know, we've got some serious candidate for yield over here. And that took a fair amount of selection. That just didn't happen by fluke, guys. A lot of time went into running and finding the perfect line here, you know what I mean? Not all Death Bubbas are equal. Just because something's a Death Bubba, it'll make it Death Bubba. Even if it's a cut, guys, even if it's a cut, we have to talk about terroir, and that's what a lot of my videos moving forward are gonna be talking about. We'll be talking about maximizing your yield. We'll be talking about terroir. We'll be talking about microbiology in the soil. We'll be talking about cover crop. We'll be talking about all of that shit. And we'll be talking about how it all comes together. And some of the stuff we still don't know yet. We're just gonna see it happen right in front of our eyes. That's what's beautiful about this, guys. That is what is so beautiful about this type of methodology. Growing indoors, no-till living organic. Telling you, man, the stink on this, the bubba. It's like fucking burnt, like burnt rubber espresso, and then this is really sweet, sweet action too. And you can just see how fucking monstrous these things are, you know? I mean, we've got them on raised beds, but if I show you the size of these things, I gotta go from the bottom. So you just go all the way up. You go up, and up, and up, and up, and up, and up, and up. And there you go. But underneath, like I said, we've got, well, cover crop. But the beds, we've got raised beds on wheels, so we can move these babies around We've got some finagling space. I mean, it's this is a fun room. Now I'm gonna show you the other room over here really quickly. It's just that it's in darkness right now, okay? So what we're doing is we've got this room here flowering 12 hours of the day, and then we've got that room over there flowering the other half of the day, okay? And it's on a flip box. So I'm gonna go show you really quickly what that room looks like in night. It's just a full room of death bubbas. This is a long intro. I wasn't expecting it to be this long, but you guys want to see the garden right now, don't you? And then you're gonna, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back and take a look at how this garden got to this point over the course of a couple videos. And I hope to have you all caught up, everyone all caught right back up in a few weeks time. But yeah, you can see in here, it's nighttime. We've also thrown up the scrog. So that's what's different in here, is we've got scrog nets going on in here. And on this side, we've also got a scrog net here, but let me see if I can get you looking in at some of this. Oh, there we go. Anyway, we got a room of, basically a whole room here of death bubbas, whereas on the other side, and these beds, guys, are about 16 feet by 4 feet long. So here, let me see if I can get a better, kind of new with this whole night shooting thing, but super important to have the green light, I know that, obviously. But I'm just trying to get a nice shot for you guys. Anyway. Yeah, so we've got, you know, a room of death bubbas. All of this entire room is in week 4.5 of flower. So they are technically on day 31 of flower right here. And we are going to yield a fucking shit ton. I'll show you from the back of the room. Here I am at the back of the room, and we're just gonna take a walk forward through the back of this room now, right? They've got that bed on that side, and we've got another bed over here on this side, right? So two beds in each room. Guys, look at those fucking death bubbas, man. Holy shit. We're gonna fucking just yield fucking monsters in here, man. Holy fuck. Especially on this side, man. Damn. All right, cool. So now that we've gone through, we've taken a look at what's going on in flowering room A and flowering room B, which are primarily the production rooms. I can show you what else we've got going on. Oh man, this is a longer intro than I thought it would be, but you know, that's just how it goes sometimes. Fuck it. Basically what's going on is I've got lighting in here. I'm about to film a soil mixing party, which we've got some bokashi, by the way, fucking finally, worm castings, a bunch of different fucking awesome amendments that I like to use over here, you know, gypsum and, you know, alfalfa meal, a few other things I'll show you. I'll make a video on that too. But you know what, actually, before we go into this room, I don't want to show you that room yet. Not yet, no. That's where we end up. All right, so in this room over here, we've just kind of set this up recently. This is more of an experimental room. In here, we've got the old ceramic metal halide mixing with LEDs. And on this side here, we've also got a couple of different styles of LEDs going on, okay? And this is just a room entirely of death bubba cuts. If I was to put those lenses over top like that, oh, and get a focus on something finally for once, there we go. So this is a room of death bubba cuts. These are all death bubbas that we're working in a different style. So this is actually not a no-till living organic style. You can see this is something else going on here altogether. We're working a different style of super soil. So in this room right now, I mean, we've just kind of cleaned it out. We don't really know what's going on with this room. So it's really, really important to inoculate not just the soil, but also introduce beneficial predators, right? So in this instance, I've got a couple. We've got, you can see it's Phytocelius persimilis. All right, so outside of the persimilis, guys, which I'm about to apply to the leaf surface, okay, I have in here a bunch of news articles, clearly. But also, we also have right here, guys, this is super crucial. This is super awesome. Stradiolaelaps simitis. Hell yeah, and there's the instructions right there. Well, it's not instructions, but it just kind of tells you what's going on. Packed in like a vermiculite type mixture. So I'm going to apply that to the soil. So that's going down here, that'll go to the soil, and they'll take care of, you know, fungus gnat larva, you know, thrip larva, stuff like that. Really, really voracious predator soil mite, formerly known as Hypoapsis miles. All right, the persimilis will go to the foliage and we'll take care of any spider mites. Oh, also, I forgot to say root aphids. So the predatory mite that goes into the soil, Stradiolaelaps cimentis, will take care of root aphids as well in the soil. So, hey man, can't go wrong there. And then at the end of it all, I'm also going to be applying a fungus gnat deterrent and just like an all around voracious predator. We've got nematodes. So I've got a bunch of nematodes that I'm gonna be spraying and applying into the soil as well, okay? So that's what we're doing for an IPM in terms of beneficial insects in this room. Now, going over to, man, this is turning into a long intro, isn't it? Holy shit. Here we are. Okay, so here we are finally. Back to kind of where I started this whole, back to where I started this whole video. Can I get focused? Can I get a focus, please? I don't know why I just can't get focus here. This is bizarre. Focus. Anyway, so it's not focusing. So my camera decided to stop focusing most of the way through this video. But, you know, these here are death bubba moms. And if I go back to that first video where I point out the death bubba moms, you can see that they've kind of grown a bit. Tied them down. They didn't seem to care too much. So it's time to take, and I like to take very large cuts too, by the way. I take massive monster cuts. And so when we're talking about monster cuts, I'm just gonna show you really quickly what I am about to transplant. And that is these monster crop cuts. Oh God, I can't focus in on this. This is like fucking bad. Anyway, these monster crops were taken at week like, here, let me show you what's going on with them. They look fucking crazy. This thing was taken week 6 flower, dude. 6.5. And you can see it's starting to come out of it. So if it's been a few weeks, but that is fucking awesome. Boom, okay, cut. Cut, 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 or maybe not. Who knows, we'll see. See if I cut. Definitely smoke a joint at some point though.